step by step, stride by stride. For Jason Dunkerley and his guide Josh Karanga, running is a team sport.
He's kind of leading and I'm following and, you know, based on his movement.
For 5 years, Karanga has guided Dunkerley to some impressive podium-worthy performances, including this one in the men's 1500-meter race earlier this week. Totally blind, Dunkerley has depended on his teammate to see him through. Most of his cues are subtle gestures with his arm.
Other than telling him how far the person is in front of us or how fast the split is, we just run.
A tether wrapped around their wrists is what connects some visually impaired runners and their guides. For sprinters, it's a tighter Velcro strap. This team's bond is so strong, running in tandem has become second nature.
You always lead with your left foot and you always go with
your
right
foot. I've never
even thought about it. Yeah, I guess so, yeah. You don't even think about it that way.
We probably should.
For others, the mechanics of their sport is highly technical.
Audrey is the pilot, I'm the stoker in the back.
Robbie Weldon is a gold medal winning paracyclist. She rides in tandem with her teammate.
I have the brakes that I need to control.
Weldon has next to no sight, so her pilot's instructions are critical in keeping their race on track.
Hitting speeds of 90 kilometers an hour with very technical, tactical courses, it's really important to have that trust in your pilot.
No matter the sport, the decision to compete with someone else is a selfless one.
And then they have to be at an Olympic level without wanting to go to the Olympics themselves.
He's helped me to kind of be ambitious, raise my own sort of expectations.
Expectations that clearly include podium finishes. These teams celebrate together. Charles Siagro, CBC News, Toronto.